When people ask me, are you an artist? Are you a photographer? Do you like black and white? Do you like color? I tell them I like all three. I like black and white and color. The situation, the difference between a straight-ahead, point-blank photographer and somebody who relates to the medium as an artist is very clearly stated in the nature of the content. What is the nature of the information? What are we trying to have the photograph imply? For me, the most important thing is that I make a picture that I can put on the wall for a long time, and it will look at me, and I can engage this image over a period of years. You know, when I went into photography, I didn't say I wanted to be recognized or famous. What I said when I brought out my first book was, I want just enough recognition to be able to do my work. No more, no less. And that's really what I got. In those days, when I was trying to sell my soul, nobody wanted to buy it anyway. So I decided that what I would do is I would work in a purely introspective fashion for myself. I could find out who and what I was through my photography. And I started working for myself, and I started making pictures that I didn't understand. And this is very, very important for me. If I don't understand my work, it means that I'm in new territory. And there's a big difference between looking at a photograph and saying, I don't know if it's good or bad. That might be neurasthenic. That might be a neurotic pain. Or you might be in territory that you never visited before. And then that would be a growing pain. And I'm in such a place right now, and I'm thrilled to be so confused in my work as I am now. Photography has always, since 1839, photography has resisted one single permanent definition. It is the most amorphous of all the media. It is used for every possible application, from the sacred to the profane. I draw most of my inspiration traditionally from painting and sculpture, but primarily painting because of its two-dimensional quality. If you want to study photography, it takes you about 3 months to learn the entire history. Whereas if you want to study the history of two-dimensional art, it just goes on and on. I was at the museum today, this late Impressionist show, and saw these Matisses that brought me to tears. There's always something that's been done essentially on the two-dimensional surface that will powerfully inform my efforts. And you never come to the end of it.
But there's something interesting in that. Oh, yeah? It is.